because of who you are, I give you praise. Because of who you are, I will lift my voice and say, Lord, I worship you because of who you are. Lord, I worship you because of who you are.
You're listening to When Christians Speak Talk Radio, a voice crying out in today's wilderness, prepare ye the way of the Lord. When Christians Speak Talk Radio is a nonprofit corporation, and our main mission is in reaching the lost with the good news of Jesus Christ and to encourage and strengthen our fellow believers. Glory to God. Our secondary mission is in the building of a communication infrastructure, and this infrastructure will connect believers outside of the walls of their local ministries. The sole purpose of this is in expanding our vision as Christ's body in the earth. This is a time when the Lord is unveiling a plan for this particular season for the advancement of His kingdom. And When Christians Speak is excited to be playing a part in that. There is only one body, one spirit. There is only one Lord, Christ Jesus. There is one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of us all, who is over all and through all and in all. This is your host this afternoon, this beautiful Thursday afternoon, on Declaring the Finished Work. Glory to God. I am here. And I will be sharing a message that was previously aired here on When Christians Speak Talk Radio for the first time in August. This message is a message that was delivered by Pastor Paul Morgan several years ago, but it is a timely message in this particular season. Pastor Paul Morgan, he is the pastor of Chosen Generation Ministries in Richmond, Virginia. And I am excited to announce that he will be joining When Christians Speak Talk Radio programming. He will be on the air every Wednesday beginning October the 20th. Glory to God. Hallelujah. I'm excited because this brother is just anointed to reach the believer and the unbeliever in a very unique way. It's not church as usual. And, you'll hear it when you begin to listen to these Wednesday broadcasts. And remember, that's Wednesday, October the 20th. That's the first airing, and it's at 7 p.m. Glory to God. Amen. Amen. So I am going to pray, and then I am going to just let this message roll. You will be blessed. It's entitled Sonship versus the Orphan Spirit. Amen. Sonship versus the Orphan Spirit. You know, I'm going to read this scripture from Romans 8, and I'm going to begin in verse 15. For you did not receive the spirit of slavery to fall back into fear, but you have received the spirit of adoption as sons, by whom we cry, Abba, Father. The Spirit Himself bears witness with our spirit that we are children of God. And if children, then heirs, heirs of God, and fellow heirs with Christ, provided we suffer with Him in order that we may also be glorified with Him. For I consider, this is Paul speaking, the Apostle Paul, for I consider that the sufferings of this present time are not worth comparing with the glory that is to be revealed to us. For the creation waits with eager longing for the revealing of the sons of God. I'm going to read that last verse, that's verse 19, Romans 8. For the creation, this is all of creation, for the creation waits with eager longing for the revealing of the sons of God. Amen. So if you still continue to define your relationship with the Lord through your performance, then you'll be blessed by this message that Pastor Paul is delivering. Sonship versus the orphan spirit. Amen. Amen. Glory to God. Father, we thank you for the broadcast today. We thank you that we have another opportunity to turn our eyes toward you, to put you in that place of honor, which is the first place in our lives. We thank you that it is your breath that is in these bodies, and we take this breath and we magnify your name today. We bless your holy name. And now I ask in the name of Jesus to just breathe over this broadcast today that it will bless and it will make free the listener, that they will begin to understand the magnitude of what our Lord and Savior Christ Jesus has done for us through the cross. So bless, multiply, prosper. It's in Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Glory to God.
Amen. I'd like to thank Pastor Robertson and Pastor Marsha for allowing me to minister today and the women's ministry. Thank you so much. I apologize for my dress. I came up to do a workshop yesterday, and Spirit talked to Pastor Marsha, and she said, God said, you need to speak today. So I'm not being disrespectful. I just didn't have a change of clothes. But clothes won't get in the way of the Holy Ghost. Y'all agree with that? All right? So what we're going to do, we're going to start out with what's called sonship versus an orphan spirit. Write this down. Every challenge that you face, every challenge that you face can be overcome by you understanding and knowing your true identity. Most problems are an identity issue. Remember when Satan came to tempt Christ? If you are the Son of God, you would do such and such. And Christ did not enter into that temptation. But he was going for his identity, because if I can get you to have a distorted identity, I can get you to live a distorted life. Now, we recognize that this is a woman's advance. But we also recognize that in sonship, there is no division. So there are three chairs and three choices. Three chairs and three choices. Sonship, or daughters. That's when you accept Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. Lord means you yield your life to His life. You allow Him to live through you. You set aside your agenda and you operate from His agenda. Whatever plans you have, you put those plans aside to make sure that His will is done. So not only are you heaven bound when you accept Him as Lord and Savior, you are also victory bound, because then He is responsible for the results. Everything that happened yesterday happened because I yielded totally to what He wanted to do. I think Pastor Marshall, I had three presentations. I only got to one of them. Because He said, do this, do that, do this, do that. When He says do it, that's when you do it. Because then I'm no longer responsible for the results. He is. So then you have an orphan spirit. An orphan spirit is one that accepts Jesus as Savior, but refuses to have Him as Lord. So you can be heaven bound, but you're not victory driven. Because see, then who is responsible for the results? If He's not your Lord, who's responsible for the results? You are. And one of the things we know about counseling is, unless you can identify where you are, you can't change. Write this down. You must acknowledge where you are in order to receive healing. Denial is a strong thing. You can deny. No, someone can tell you the truth, and you can deny that truth. Now, will that truth benefit you? No. Because it's truth that you have not decided to walk in. There's four stages of change. We talked about it yesterday. Stage number one, have you ever mentioned to somebody? Have you ever thought about? And when they say no, that's stage number one. No thoughts about change. Haven't even thought about it. Number two, thinking about change. That's where you're looking at it, you're examining it, but you're not quite ready to take that step. Step number three, steps towards change. You're starting to do a little bit. You know, like let's say if you decide to go to college, you're actually filling out the application. You're actually collecting money to do so. And then the fourth one is changing. That's where you're doing things towards change. So unless you're willing to make a change, listen to where people are. They tell you where they are. You have to determine what stage of change they're at. Number three, that chair is unsaved. Now, these are the people that will say, Jesus, who? Who are you talking about? They'll say, Allah. So we got an unsaved chair. Does that look attractive to you? Unless you got a lot of padding back here, that don't look attractive. You got the daughter or the sonship chair. That's your rightful place. And you have the orphan spirit. Now, what I want to do is I'm going to give you some scriptures. Go back one. Turn to Galatians chapter 4, verse 4 through 7. Or you can just look at the screen. Galatians chapter 4, verse 4 through 7. But when the fullness of time had come, God sent forth His Son, born of a woman, born under the law, to redeem those who were under the law, that we might receive the adoption as sons. The thing about adoption that's different than being born into a natural family is, in adoption, you can choose who you want. You can say, yeah, I want him, but no, I don't want him. I want him. So God chose us, handpicked as His sons. And because you are sons, God has sent forth the Spirit of His Son into your hearts, crying out, Abba, Father. Therefore, you are no longer a slave, but a son. No longer a slave, but a son. And if a son, then an heir of God through Christ. So what is an heir? I'm the type pastor, you can talk back to me. What is an heir? What does it mean when they say you are heir? Inheritance. Inherit what? You inherit whatever the father has. So as he has unlimited ability, unlimited resources, what do you have as a son? I was teaching at a class one day, and a gentleman got really upset with me because I told him we were talking about Christianity. He said, no, you're a black man first, and then you're a Christian. And I said, no, I'm a Christian first, and then I'm a black man. And he said, well, why would you want to be that? I said, if I'm a black man first, I'm limited by what a black man has done. But if I'm a Christian, I have unlimited potential and unlimited resources. So sometimes you just got to agree to disagree. Because he decided, no, I want to be a black man first. And I said, go ahead. And I'm not saying this had anything to do with it. But he died 3 days later. As a black man. Galatians chapter 3, verse 28. Because when I mention the word sonship, I don't want you to think that God is sexist. Because he's not. There is neither Jew nor Greek. There is neither slave nor free. There is neither male nor female. For you are all, everybody say all, one in Christ Jesus. So when I speak of son or sonship, whereas daughters are not listed in biblical times, because only the son received the inheritance, we know today that in Christ there is no favorite. There is neither male nor female in the spirit. So when I use sons in a generic term, that also includes daughters. Say daughters.
Daughters.
All right. Turn to Ephesians chapter 1, verse 13 through 22. Ephesians chapter 1, verse 13 through 22. In him you also trusted, after that you heard the word of truth, the gospel of your salvation, in whom also, having believed, you were sealed with the Holy Spirit of promise, who is the guarantee of our inheritance. So the Holy Spirit sealed us, and when he sealed us, he guaranteed us the inheritance. Sometimes you see it, sometimes you don't. But if you don't see it, it does not mean that you don't have it. That's why you need to sit in that chair. There's something about sitting in your rightful place that allows you to see different. Until the redemption of the purchased possession to the praise of his glory. Therefore, I also, after I heard of your faith in the Lord Jesus and your love for all saints, do not cease to give thanks for you, making mention of you in my prayers. I mentioned yesterday, it's very important to keep your pastor and pastor's wife up in prayer, because nobody knows what they go through to make sure that you get protected, that you get the word of God, that you get the freedom of God. They look over your souls. So make it easier for them. Write this down. Whatever position you're in, stay two steps ahead of that position. That's how you get promoted. By staying two steps ahead of that position, what it is that you make your pastor's and his wife's job easier. So if you're a greeter, don't just think in terms of greeting. Think two steps ahead of that. If you're an usher, think two steps ahead of that. See things the way they would see it. It makes their job easier. Turn to Romans chapter 8. Verse 5 through 9. Because we want to talk about those three chairs. And at any time as a ministry, there are characteristics of, we won't even deal with the characteristics of the unsaved. We're just going to deal with sonship, a daughter, and an orphan. So I passed out some characteristics. And at any time, those people who have those cards can just come up and take whichever chair you believe that is. And as I'm going through this process, I want you to identify where you are. Because what you'll see is at any time, you can go from an orphan to sonship just by an act of your will, just by changing the way you think, just by staying two steps ahead. Those who live according to the flesh have their mind set on what the flesh desires. So what does the flesh desire? Stuff. What kind of stuff? Material stuff. Is there anything wrong with having material stuff?
No.
Is nothing wrong with?
No.
Don't let it be your idol.
Right.
Don't let it have you. What else does flesh desire? Who said sex? All right, appreciate your honesty. They were like, no, nobody was like, no, nobody's going to say that. Yeah, yeah, they said it, Pastor. They said sex. Sex, sex, sex. What else? What else does flesh desire? Write this down. The scripture says, I give it a say, sex should never be satisfied, but the scripture says that sin can never be satisfied. Can't be satisfied. Remember that commercial? Bet you can't eat just one? That's right. Tried to eat one potato chip, didn't work. So what seat do you think the flesh goes in? You think unsaved? Mm-hmm. Unsaved? Okay. Let's keep going. But those who live according with the Spirit have their mind set on what the Spirit desires. So what does the Spirit desire? Y'all talking about sex for... What does the Spirit desire? God's desires. Okay, so what's the godly desire? Love, joy, happiness, peace, temperance, long-suffering. Against such, there is no law. The mind governed by the flesh is death, but the mind governed by the Spirit is life and peace. The mind governed by the flesh is hostile to God. It does not submit to God's law, nor can it do so. Those who are in the realm of the flesh cannot please God. Everybody say cannot?
Cannot.
Please God. You, however, are not in the realm of the flesh, but are in the realm of the Spirit. If indeed the Spirit of God lives in you. And if anyone does not have the Spirit of Christ, they do not belong to God. So what year is that? Unsaved. 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 1 through 3. 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 1 through 3. However, brethren, I could not talk to you as spiritual, but as to non-spiritual. Men of the flesh, in whom the carnal nature predominates, as to mere infants in the new life in Christ, unable to talk yet. So you saved, but you're in the orphan chair. Because look what he said in verse 2. I feed you with milk, not solid food, for you were not yet strong enough to be ready for it. You ever approach somebody and try to share with them something you saw, something that you knew could help them, and they were not ready to receive it? What did they say? What's some ways that they kick back at you? Huh? That's all right? What else they say? That sounds good, but, the big but, okay. But can keep you from getting healed. What else? I'm listening. Who say I'm listening? I'm listening. What are they listening past? They say they were listening. What else? So they say, I'm good. Oh, I'm good. I'm good. I get back to you. Huh? Oh, God hadn't told me that. What else? Huh? I got to do what? I got to clean myself up first. Whatever. What? Y'all need to go more spiritual on me now. Because you... Oh, no, they didn't say, let me pray about it. Okay, let me pray about it. All right, go. Okay, y'all on the right track. Pastor Marshall, what you heard? What's some of the things you heard? What is it? God knows my heart. Yes, he do. He knows my heart. What else y'all hear? No, she didn't. She said, I don't receive that. But you're going to receive today, though, right? All right, okay, just checking. All right, what else? What other stuff they come at you? Pastor, you done heard it all. I know y'all done heard it all. I know me and Curly, we starting to hear it all. All right, I'm move on. I'm going to stop picking on folk. Then y'all going to have to pray for me. All right, verse 3. For you are still unspiritual, having the nature of the flesh under the control of ordinary impulses. For as long as there are, envying, jealousy, wrangling, and frictions among you, are you not unspiritual and of the flesh? Is that really where you want to be? What brought you over to Christ anyway? Did you get tired of getting beat up? Well, we're going to find out in a minute. Behaving yourselves after the human nature and live and like mere unchanged men. So we want to be changed today. We want to identify where we are so we can decide what chair we want to sit in. So y'all ready for some characteristics? Orphan spirit. Y'all ready? Sees God as a taskmaster. What does that mean? Taskmaster. Master. What's a taskmaster? Hard. So for a taskmaster, what I got to do? I got to work hard. I got to strive. An orphan is independent and self-reliant. I don't need you. What do I need you for? But is that scripture? Scripture says, can the foot say to the hand, I have no need of you? So we got to work together, but not with an orphan. Orphans say, I got it all together. An orphan, they depend on their own gifts and talents. They depend on their own gifts and talents. They are convinced that they cannot trust anyone. Anybody you know ever give you a task and they watch behind you, micromanage? They watch you, they watch you, they watch you, they watch you. Write this down. Parents stand in the place of God. So when a child is little, what happens is, we as parents stand in the place of God. So whatever they see us do, they think God does. So we need to watch how we walk, watch how we live, because that's how children will interpret that's how God is. Now let's see how a son feels. He sees God as a loving father. A sonship, he lives a interdependent. So what is interdependent? I need you. What's that song Bonnie used to sing? I need you, you need me. I think it was Bonnie. Was it Bonnie? It was Bonnie? Y'all hear children watch Bonnie, didn't you? They're not going to admit it, Pastor. They're not going to admit they watch Bonnie. Okay, all right. I need you, you need me. Okay, all right. So interdependent means that, write this down. God has created, he said in the word, that every man must give account of himself to God. So my wife has a destiny, I have a destiny, and we will both give account of what that destiny is. But then we come together to make sure that my weak parts are her strengths and her weak part are my strengths. So write this down. Say different. Everybody repeat after me. Different is good. Because if everybody was like me, no, she didn't say, Lord, Lord, Lord. Oh, no, I'm just joking. She said, oh, no. No, I'm just joking. So the challenges that we have in relationships is when we try to change each other so that they'll be more like you. You follow me? So we call it a value system. The way I see money and the way you see money might be different. But I'm going to try to get you to see the money, the value about money, the way I see the value about money. So what will our conflicts be about? Money. Because I'm trying to get you to change so that you will see it the way I see it. In reality, we need that input. We need that viewpoint. Write this down. The reason why I want you to be like me is because it's easier for me to deal with me than it is to learn you. Now, y'all going to have to tell me what I said. That was purely anointing, brother, purely anointing. I know I got some fast writers here. What did I say? What did I say? Okay. All right. As long as y'all got it. They got it, Pastor. I can tell when it's not me and it's him. That's why I'm talking about interdependent. All right. So any of you guys, being honest with you now, which side, based off what you just saw up there, which side you on? Do you see God as a taskmaster? Or do you see him as a loving father? See, that was a little slow, Pastor. That was a little slow. I'm not sure about that one. Do you see him as, are you interdependent or interdependent? Look at sonship. Completely dependent on their heavenly Father, just as Jesus was. What did Jesus say? Without my Father, I can do nothing. So now, if that's Jesus, God manifested in the flesh, what chance you think you got that you can do something without him? But why we try? Why we try? So let's see what else the orphan spirit got going on. They say, orphan spirit, insecurity and lack peace. When it's time to go to sleep, there's not a lot of sleep going on there. Because there's a lot of things you're trying to figure out and work out among yourself instead of relying and resting in him. Now, another thing about an orphan is they mask their insecurities. Y'all know what mask is? Okay. Now, let's go secular and then let's go spiritual. All right, so what are some secular ways we mask our insecurities? Who said? Lie? Okay, that's just straight up then. Y'all just went straight there, okay? All right, I thought y'all were going to warm up or something. It just went straight to lying. All right, sister, brother, whoever said that. All right, so what's another way we mask our lie? They say they lie. Avoidance? Okay, all right, what else? Who? Covering? Cover up, okay? Cover up. Camouflage. Denial. Joning. Okay, talking about people. Okay, all right. What else? Blame shifting. All right, now let me go spiritual. All right, let me see who's going to speak up. All right. How you cover your mask in the church now? You're in the church. Oh, who said praise the Lord? But that's not how they say it. How they say it with the slang on it? Praise the Lord. Y'all hearing people talk about God? Who's that? Who's God? Come on now. Who? What else they say? Sing it out. What else? What else they say? Blessed and highly favored. Blessed and highly favored. Okay. Huh? All is well in the garden? Okay. Too blessed to be stressed. Wait a minute, y'all talking in tongues now. Wait a minute, hold on, y'all talking in tongues. Hold on. Give me a hand or something so I can call on you, because y'all tongues interpretation. Got the Jesus bumper sticker on the car. What that going to do for you? They're going to give you a pocket space? What? Now, see, Pastor ain't meddling with people. Yes, ma'am. The way they dress. Okay, they're going to mask how they dress. Okay, all right. Y'all know anybody like that? Yeah, yes, y'all do. Pastor laughing. He said, near mind redemption wouldn't be available if y'all did. Oh, no. Pastor, I ain't say nothing, Pastor. I ain't say nothing. Go ahead. Come on. No, they don't. The jewelry cross. Big cross. She said a Flavor Flav cross. Pastor, I always got a job here. Okay, the Flavor Flav cross. Yes, ma'am. They mask the Bible and what? Oh, they master the Bible so they can make you think they got knowledge. No, she didn't. Force field. So you had people do that on you, huh? Okay, all right. I'm going to leave masking alone because y'all got that damn pet. They strive to act right and do enough to please God and earn his blessings. How you going to earn something that's already been given? That's how a son sees it now. Son says, he's already given me the blessing. But an orphan thinks, I got to do more, I got to pray more, I got to fast more, There's nothing wrong with any of those things. But it's not to earn his blessings. He's already given you that. They feel with uncertainty or fear of trusting and intimacy. Well, what's intimacy? And don't say sex, because y'all already used sex word already. What else can intimacy be? Love? Relationship? Closeness? Time with them? Who said time? Time well spent. And when you talk about looking at TV, just cut the TV off and listen to what people saying. All right? Write this down. When your wife come in the room, or spouse come in the room, or child come in the room, or somebody, and they talking and you watch the TV, just put the TV on mute. Just put the TV on mute. What did that show them? You interested in them? Interested in hearing what they got to say? You care. Instead of cutting it up. See, some of y'all be cutting the thing up. What do you say? What do you say? Hey, what do you say? Y'all got to stop that stuff. Okay, all right. Sonship. Let's see. Sonship. Confidence, peace, and rest in God's presence and his embrace. So you're comfortable being by yourself. You're comfortable in God's embrace. You're comfortable being with him. They are secure in God and does not depend on their behavior, but is based on the grace of God. Write this down. Grace is God's empowerment to do what naturally can't be done. Yeah, if you guys, as I'm ministering, and you see or hear something, go ahead and just, we got some tape. We need some tape, because I want you to tape it all over the place. Check my bag. I should have some. Yeah, we can get some tape, because I want you to see it. I'm visual. How many of y'all are visual people? Let me see. Yeah. Most of y'all are visual. Okay. Grace is God's empowerment to do only that which God can do, that humanly couldn't be done. Uh-oh. Y'all ready for this one? Y'all thought the mask was intense. Y'all know anybody to strive for approval? Don't look at nobody beside y'all. So an orphan strives for praise, approval, and acceptance of man. How to do? That's what they say. How to do? It was good. How good was it?
No.
See, I got to find somebody else to tell me how good I did. Because what is the orphan looking for? They're looking for your acceptance. They're looking for your approval. So if you don't say anything or you say it was good, they're going to ask you, well, how good was it? And if you said, well, like he said, then you got to find somebody else. Oh, excuse me. An orphan spirit, counterfeit strying leads to the fear of failure and rejection. Their fear is that they can't do it good enough. See, the thing about, let me go ahead over to a sonship. A sonship, yeah, put it on the back. There you go. A sonship is totally accepted in God's love. Everybody say totally accepted in God's love. So, if I mess up, what I got to back me? God's love. Do you write this down? Do you know, let me say it first, then you decide how to write. Do you know you can mess up when you're in God's love and he can still make it work? But if I am orphan spirit driven, then what happens is I got to depend on me getting it right and him not adding anything to it. Sonship. They don't have to strive for approval because in Christ they already have. Guys, Christians are tired. I had one service where I got my stuff all ready. We're going to go to the Lord. We're going to have us a good time. And God told me, he said, your people are tired. Tell them to lay down, and I'll minister to them while they're asleep, and they will awaken refreshed and renewed. So we just What I told them, exactly what he told them. I just say, lay down in your seats. Now, of course, some Christians have a problem with that because they were from the orphan spirit side that they got to perform. Some sisters had a problem with that because they had spent some money on their hairdo. Now, I'm not lying to you. Can I show you something? This is how some Christians lay it down. Pastor, I wish I was lying. I said, how you laying there like that? How you resting like that? I'm all right. I'm all right. God's going to work with me. I'm all right. I can have my head tilted up. He's still going to speak to me. Kelly was with me. She's not. You know, some people couldn't lay down. Write this down. Obedience brings the blessing. Some people didn't get nothing, Pastor, because they weren't obedient to what the word was ministered. Then you know how y'all have gift cards. You know, gift cards. Okay, yeah, y'all got gift cards. You know how you have the visitor sheets? And so, you know, we had visitor sheets filled out, and Curly called, you know, she called the people and welcomed them, thank them for coming. And one lady said, is he going to teach next week, or we going to lay down again? I wish I could tell you she came back, but she didn't come back. She was one of the sisters that set up like that, though. All right, guys, I got to keep going. Y'all got issues. Now, I want you to get this. If you don't get nothing else in the whole workshop today, get this. Orphans, here, let me show it to you so that way you can say you saw it. Orphans perform for love to impress God and others. How are you going to impress somebody who's already impressed with you? How are you going to do it? But look what a sonship does. Because I am loved, I perform. Two totally separate places, guys. That takes the heat off, that takes the work off, that takes the pressure off. Because I'm loved, I perform. So whether you say thank you, please, it was great, doesn't matter. Because I'm loved, I'm performing. Check this out. Remember, Jesus didn't do one miracle until after he came up out of the water after being baptized, and he heard his father say, "This is my beloved son in whom I'm well pleased." Once he knew he was loved, he started to perform. Once you know you love, you'll start to perform. But it'll be from a totally different place because you're not trying to earn something. You're just giving based off the fact that you loved. In an orphan, the service is motivated by earning God's and man's favor. Let me tell you something about earning man's favor. As an orphan, can I get you to come up for a second? Just want you to hold that for a second. This is what happened when we perform for love and we serve based off of motivation to be accepted. Can you hear me that box? Can you hear me that box? Can you hear me that box? At any time, man can move the gauge by which acceptance is manifested. So you, as that man, have to decide, or you as that woman, have to decide, how far am I willing to go to see to it that you accept me? Thank you. But when I'm loved by God, I can determine. My worth is not based off how I serve or who I serve. You see somebody on the street and you can serve them because you know you love. But if it's performance driven, I got to make sure somebody sees me. So I got to, you know, I see this piece of trash as I'm walking up to the church. I got, you know, I see the trash. Some of y'all saw the trash. They saw the trash, Pastor. But then it's like, okay, I see the trash. What is that the pastor car? Hey, Pastor, I got it, Pastor. I'm good. I got it, Pastor. You know he passed by, Pastor, and he didn't pick it up, but I got it, Pastor. I'm telling y'all about performance, man. Y'all see some people? Y'all see some people? All right, Curl, I'm going to move on. Orphan spirit.
Y'all got a lot of stuff up on that card.
Orphan spirit. Self-rejection from comparing yourself to others. Uh-oh. What I'm talking about there, people? Self-rejection by comparing yourself to others. So you're not good enough being who you are. You're only good enough once you compare. Write this down. In comparison, you always lose because you compare their strengths to your weaknesses. Comparison is never done from your strengths to their weaknesses. Comparison is always done from your weaknesses to their strengths. So if you hear somebody say, "Sis, you can sing," in an orphan spirit, the mindset says, "Wait a minute, I just sung 5 minutes before her. Why they didn't say that to me?" Have you ever noticed that you can have this whole session right here? When I come over here, they smile. They smile at me. Except this one person. She don't smile at me. Okay? But what is the comparison spirit going to do? It won't see all the people that's smiling. It's just going to focus on the one that didn't. Y'all got me? Everybody in church speak to you, but one person. What do you do? One person. You know what happened? Such and such didn't speak to me. But what about the 900 people that did? But that's what an orphan spirit is going to do. It's going to focus on the negative. But a son recognizes that he's totally accepted, or she's totally accepted by God, regardless of their past mistakes and their present mistakes. His blood has already made an allocation for the mistakes that you are going to make. It's already there. All you have to do is appropriate what he's already done. Sonship, his value, comes from God. Guys, you got to grab that thing. His value comes from God. Mighty quiet. Okay, let's look at this next one. Orphan spirit. Y'all read that without laugh. Cannot genuinely rejoice over the success or advancement of others. What does that mean? Who said jealous? Jealous. She said it right. She said doggone right. I said it. Jealous. They can't be happy about other people's stuff. Man, I got a new house. What? You robbed the bank? I know your credit. How come you got a house? Well, I got a house. How come? No. How come the pastor asked you to speak and he didn't ask me? I was here when the forefathers came. And before the church was even birthed, before he even thought about the church, I was here. But he didn't ask me to speak. How come? Y'all know people like Pastor, I'm going to walk over here. He said, please walk over there. Jealousy towards others' success and position. Y'all know anybody like that? They call your prayer partner. You believe for a job, they believe for a job. They get the job first. You tell them what they say. How you get the job before I did? Matter of fact, my tithe is more than yours. But I thought his love was not based off performance. No, I'm going to walk over here this time. All right, so let's look at what else how son interprets. Securing their father's identity and position so we rejoice in other people's blessings. So we get excited when other people get blessed. Man, y'all was excited about people that were getting healed yesterday. Man, let me tell you. I didn't think we were going to get out of church last night. It turned into night too, Pastor. It turned into night, man. What we eat at last night? 10 o'clock. 10 o'clock. Carrabba's. Yeah. I mean, it's like, man, it just kept going. Like the Energizer Bunny. Kept going and going and going. If y'all was listening, I'm going to keep on giving you the word. All right, so what happened with these people? Humility and unity is their core value. But write this down. I can disagree without being disagreeable. I can disagree without being disagreeable. But I can be peaceful while I'm in disagreement. Now, Pastor, no. Y'all don't agree with the pastor about everything. So what y'all do when y'all not agree with the pastor about everything?
Be quiet.
Oh, no. Be quiet. Okay. All right. Pray. All right. What else? What do you say? What do you say?
Leave the church.
All right. So which side is that? Is that Orphan or that Sonship? Orphan. What else they do, Marsh? Stop speaking. Okay. Oh, who said gospel? Now, how they say that, though? They don't just say they gospel. Let's pray for them. But first of all, I got to tell you what happened. Because I need you to know all the details. And matter of fact, while I'm giving you the detail, I need to tell you some more stuff that I know about them. So you can pray for that, too. But don't tell nobody I told you. Don't tell nobody I started it. But let me know how the prayer went. Because, see, I'm not going to stay on the line to pray. I just wanted to make sure you knew everything. Yeah, so that you would pray. Because, you know, when you pray, you get answers. See, y'all not right. Y'all got issues. All right, I got to move on. Let's see what else the sun and we going south now. An orphan spirit. They self focus. They build themselves up by turning others down. So the only way they can go up is to push you down. She sung that song last week. But I got a new song. How else do Christians turn Christians down? Because remember, orphan spirit, you saved, but you just not walking in the things of God. So how do Christians turn Christians down? Her spirit just didn't agree with me. What else?
Rumors.
Okay, rumors. All I got to do is create doubt. Why they wearing them shoes? Y'all know that's the only pair of shoes they got. No, keep going. Self-focus. How do I bring attention to myself? That's what an orphan does. They destroy relationships by controlled criticism and lack of respect and honor. They'll talk about the pastor. I've been pastoring now for a year and a couple months. And what I learned early on was, boy, the things that a pastor goes through, and I'm just being straight up honest with you, you don't have no right to tell the pastor how he ought to run the church. I mean, that thing makes me want to cry. Because, guys, you don't have a clue what goes on behind the scenes. I'm not trying to scare you. I'm just trying to awaken you to the realities. See, God put us in charge of your souls. So before we even say anything to you, we have gone to the Father to see how to address it. Not only how, but when to address it. Not only when to address it, but if to address it. And sometimes, when you come at us the wrong way, we got to pray that you don't die where you stand. That's the office that He's given us. And the first lady, the pastor's wife, my wife, they put up with stuff from them orphan spirit folk. They spiritual. I'm telling you. Write this down. Grieve when you see it and not when it's done. Grieve, you know, like you grieve something. Grieve when you see it and not when it's done. And I'll tell you what that means. Pastor Rob and Pastor Marsha, they see certain people drift off. That's when they start to grieve for them. They don't wait till they have left the church and started saying ugly things. That's when I say grieve when you see it and not when it's done. So, for example, let me give you a natural example. So, my dad died of a heart failure. I started grieving for my dad when he went to the doctor the second time. He had four heart attacks. So when he had the second heart attack, I started grieving his death then because I recognized that it was happening more frequent. So when it came time for my dad to pass, I had already grieved his loss. See, the Spirit of God never shows you anything without you either interceding or resting in it. But you cannot say that you didn't see it coming because the Holy Spirit would be a liar. Because he said, I'll take the things of God and I'll show it unto you. So that's what I mean as pastors. We grieve the loss when we see it. When we see rebellion happen before us. And believe me, we hear stuff. You might think you told sister so-and-so and they didn't tell anybody. It gets back to us. Now you in leadership. Now so we got a process. I wouldn't think a leader would say that. So we grieve the loss then. I'm going to move on. Sonship. How do they see this thing? Relationship oriented. We cover, not hide, others' faults as we seek to restore them in the spirit of love and gentleness. We cover, not hide. Meaning that, okay, you in sin? We know you in sin. But you don't see the office door that's shut. You don't see that we have pulled that person aside and discussed and talked with. We didn't blast your business out in the street. But because if you're orphan driven, you want them to be exposed. I'm going to move on, Pastor. How much time I got? It's 12:14. I'm looking good? Okay. 10 minutes. Okay, I can do it in 10. Okay. Orphan spirit sees authority as a source of pain. Uh-oh. So if under the anointing of God, your pastoral head shares something with you, you're going to see that as a source of pain. That's how they see authority. They have a trouble submitting to authority. And write this down. Unteachable. Not open to change. So you got to locate yourself. Am I that? Am I not open to change? When you go to tell me something, can I hear it? Write this down. Without change, there is no growth. Without change, there is no growth. A son, respectful and honorable, sees authority as ministers of God for our good. A son is teachable and open to change. Now, we might not like what we hear. Anytime, okay, write this down. Anytime someone shares something with you, take it to the Holy Spirit. He's the teacher. Say, Holy Spirit, what do you think about what they just shared? And he won't guide you into false things. All right, since I only got 10 minutes, I'm going to slip a couple. But I'm going to ask you a couple things. Oh, okay, okay, that's good. That'll work. Orphan lives as a bondage and a slave. Fear and mistrust. Self-reliance is their lifestyle. They just don't trust people. But a son is free. Get addicted to freedom. Somebody asked me, they said, how quick should I forgive? And my answer back to them was, how quick do you want to be free? I'm going to give you a demonstration that we gave yesterday about bondage, about anger, and what it does. I need somebody to turn to Psalms 91, and you're going to play God. And I need a young, let me get a man this time, because man, me and they kind of, Okay, let me get a man. Let me get a man. What? That's a big man. So I'm gonna stay on his good side. All right, brother, how you doing? Stand day, brother, stand day. All right, stand right here, facing this way. All right. Okay, who gonna be God? You better be a big God. Come on up. Who gonna be God? I need a man as a God. Come on, John. Come. All right, I need a mic. Give me a mic. Give me a hand here. Thank you. You got Psalms 91? Okay. All right, now, I'm going to show you what bondage looks like. All right, you there? All right, hold on a second. All right. I'm going to get you turned this way. All right, can y'all see him? Can the camera, can you see him? Okay. Now, you're going to start reading the scripture. But see, he has an issue with God. He's angry at God and man. All right, so he's representing God. The first thing that anger and resentment attacks is your ears. So I need a man to come up and grab his ears. You grab them soft, though. Look, ain't nobody moving fast. Okay, all right, look. No. Okay, you go ahead and start reading. Go ahead and start reading. You God. You trying to talk to him. Now, do I need to get you to... Okay, all right, I'm going to get you turned this way. All right, there you go. That way we can reach him. You come right here, God.
All right.
God look like he's scared. No, God ain't scared. Come on, God. Come on. All right, you ready?
Yes.
All right, cover this.
Psalm 91.
Come on.
He that dwelleth in the secret place of the
second
Most High
thing that anger and resentment grab
shall abide
is sight
under the shadow of
can I get
heaven.
A man?
I will say of the Lord.
Now, he can see God, but can he hear?
He is my refuge and my fortress, my God.
So you got to cover his eyes.
In him will I
trust.
Surely he shall deliver thee from the snare.
So now
of
he
fallen.
Can't hear God. He can't see God. And at least he can talk to God, right? I need a man to come up and cover his mouth.
He
now
shall
he can't
cover
talk
thee
to God. He scared to even touch the man.
With his feathers and under his wing.
Cover that.
Shall I trust his truth? Shall be his.
Cover his mouth. Now he can't see, hear God.
Buckler.
He can't
Thou
see God. He can't talk to God.
For the terror by night.
Now. You stood up, sir. Let me get you. Come on up.
That flies.
Now you got to grab his heart.
No, for the pestilence that walketh in darkness.
Because now he can't feel God.
No, for the
God.
Destruction that wasteth at noonday.
God is still talking. God never changed
the
voice.
Shall
now I need a man to come up
and
attack his body.
At our right hand. But it shall
now
not come nigh thee.
Now, did the enemy sneak in or come in?
Because thou hast made the Lord.
Did God stop talking? But he's choosing not to forgive.
Even
he's
the most
choosing
high
to be in bondage.
Thy habitation.
Are you in bondage?
There shall no evil befall
But at
thee.
Any moment, he can say, Father,
neither shall any
help me.
Come now.
Y'all got to fall off, man.
For he shall give his angels
I choose to forgive.
Over thee.
I choose to forgive. Thank you, gentlemen.
To keep thee.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Amen.
Amen.
So write this down. When will you decide to be free? Because it's in your mouth. Freedom is in your mouth. He said, who shall ascend and bring Jesus down? No, he's nigh thee in their mouth and in their heart. So at any moment, you can say, Father, forgive me. I did this in Richmond, and I had a young lady that had a stroke. And she had a stroke, and she was unable to talk and move for 2 days. And she started crying when I showed, this is what God showed me about anger and resentment. And she said, for 2 days, those nurses abused me. She wasn't expected to live, much less expected to talk. And she said, I saw bondage in a way that happened to me. So at any moment, you can choose to be free. So I'm asking you a question. based off what you see here. See, this is one thing about the power of God. That's an orphan spirit. At any time, once you walk in the things of God, you can take what's called self-rejection, and it can be covered by acceptance in Jesus Christ. You can take anything from self-focused. Where y'all want to put it? We can put it under freedom. So at any time, just by act of our will, we can go from this side to this side. Who will go from the orphan? At any time, that seat is open. That seat is available. At any time. So let's bless ourselves. I'm going to lead you in a prayer. I think we got it. You know what decree and proclaim means? Because you sit in that seat, you will decree a thing and it shall be established. Now that won't work if you're sitting in that seat, because your words only have the power of who's backing that, and that's you. Don't even think about using that chair to proclaim anything, because it has no power. Because he said, all power has been given unto me, and I give it to you. So, let's make a confession. I decree, proclaim these blessings upon my life and family in the name of Jesus. I ask you to continually release your angels to minister and strengthen me and my family by protecting us from sickness, harm, and accidents. I loose into my life in the lives of my family, friends, finances, and ministry the tangible manifestation of ongoing, life-changing, firsthand experiences of receiving in my possession in abundance, now without delay, your divine love, favor, forgiveness, your glory, power, might, patience, fire, continue infilling, kingly anointing, your divine eyesight, divine energy, divine passion, divine encounters, seasoned speech, supernatural exposure and promotion, spirit of obedience, health, signs, wonders, revelation, understanding, prosperity, justice, humility, truth, wealth, money, goodness, open heaven experience. I pronounce that I receive right now the full tangible manifestation of these confessions today, tomorrow, and forevermore. In Jesus' name, amen. Go ahead and give them a shout. Glory. Pay in full. Pay in full. The IRS says that they have to have the time and date stamp on when that income tax was sent to them. Write down the time and date stamp. I got 12/26. That is the time that it happened. What is the date of the day? May 5th. That is when in the spirit realm that manifested in your life. Whoever wins in court is the one who has the most evidence. When the enemy comes to you and says you don't have kingly anointing, when he comes to say that you're not operating in the things of God, you say, but on May the 5th at 12/26, that's when it manifested in my life. I'd like to have every head bowed and every eye closed.
praise God. That was Pastor Paul Morgan. He is the pastor and founder of Chosen Generations Ministries, located in Richmond, Virginia. Amen. Amen. So it is time for us to step into our inheritance. We are joint heirs with Christ Jesus. We are the sons of God. All of creation is groaning and travailing, waiting for this manifestation of the sons of God in the earth. Praise God. I want to remind you that all of our broadcasts are available as podcasts. You can subscribe to our podcast on iTunes or Zoom or blueberry.com. You can also download our app, WCS Talk Radio, at the Google Play Store or the Apple Store for your devices. Amen. And you'll find hundreds of podcasts out there. Praise God. Also, check out our Facebook pages, When Christians Speak Talk Radio. You'll find information about upcoming broadcasts, upcoming guests. We try and keep you abreast of what's going on and what you can look forward to. Also, you can visit our website, whenchristianspeak.com. Amen, amen. Also, if you are a listener on Spreaker.com, you can also pick up our broadcast on Spreaker.com, also on iHeartRadio, on Stitcher. It's on SoundCloud and TuneIn, and also featured on YouTube. So we praise God for these opportunities that have opened up for the broadcast to just continue to spread the good news of Jesus Christ. Also, as I said at the beginning of the show, Pastor Paul Morgan will be joining us Wednesday, every Wednesday at 7 p.m. beginning October 20th. So we'll be reminding you about this, but you'll be blessed. You'll be blessed, and we here at When Christians Speak Talk Radio are excited about Pastor Paul joining us in the perfecting of the saints, in the delivering of the good news of Jesus Christ to the lost. So praise God, and thank you for joining me today. Tomorrow night, don't forget, we've got Friday Night Joy with Reverend Ray and friends. Glory to God. Amen. And then on Sunday, we have a week in review with Reverend Ray. So praise God. Be blessed. Be blessed. Walk in your position as a son of God as you move through the remainder of your day. God is with you. Amen. He that is in you is greater than he that is in the world. You are more than a conqueror. Glory to God. God bless you and be blessed.
Because of who you are, I give you glory. Because of who you are, I give you praise. Because of who you are, I will lift my voice and say, Lord, I worship you. Because I worship you.